Good morning everyone. Today I am going to present programmable logic array, that means PLA. PLA is a fixed architecture device with programmable AND gates followed by programmable OR gates. Applications of PLA. PLA is used to provide control over data path. Second, PLA is used as a counter. Third, PLA is used as a decoder. And fourth, PLA is used as a bus interface in programmed input outputs. Programmable logic array consists of two level AND or circuit on a single chip. The number of AND OR gates and their inputs are given PLA chips and gate provided product term OR gate. Logically sum this product term and generate SOP expressions. It has M inputs, small N product terms and capital N output, and can be used to implement functions of capital M variables with N output. Internal architectures of PLA is given in figures. The block diagram of PLA. First is N capital M inputs, input buffer, output is complement and uncomplement form. That is, input is M, the output of input buffer is 2M. Now this output is connected to N matrix. N matrix also give the product term denoted by P0 to PN. This product term also connect in OR matrix. This product term as a input in OR matrix and output is a sum. Sum is represented by S, that means S0, S1, that is SN-1, that is capital N terms. After this, connect the flip-flop inverter and non-inverter circuit. This inverter non-inverter depends on sum is inverting and non-inverting. This inverting non-inverting also connect to flip-flop output buffer, flip-flop taken by SR flip-flops, and get Q output as a F0, F1, F2 to FN-1. This is the basic block diagrams. Now explain the each block diagram of PLA. First, input buffer. Examples, I0 as a input, get the two outputs I0 and I0 bar. Bubbles indicate the complement form, that I0 input as get I0 complements. Now N matrix give a inputs I0, I0 bar, I1, I1 bar, ... IM-1 or IM-1 bar. That is 2M inputs, get outputs P0, P1, P2, P3. This P0, P1, P2, P3 is also the inputs of OR gates. This diagram explained by AND gate. This I0, I1, I2, IM-1 as a input. This invert to convert input buffer to I0, I0 complement, I1, I1 complement, ... IM-1 and IM-1 complement. This output is also as a input of AND gates. This AND gates provide the product of P0, P1, P2, PN-1. Now this is the complete AND gate. Now this AND gate outputs as a input in OR gates, and OR gate outputs is sum in sum form. For next, the OR matrix. OR matrix use the product logical sum of the produce logical sum of product term. Output of AND matrix, the output of the OR matrix are obtained S0 through SN-1, where output S0 is given by S0 is equal to P0 product term, plus p1 product term plus dot dot pn minus 1 product terms, where p0, p1 dot dot pn minus 1 are the product term. Now OR matrix give the output S0, S1, S2, S3. For example, P0, P1, Pn minus 1 as an input of OR gates, output gets S0, so on. The next, I see the P0, P1, P2, Pn minus 1, all N inputs is connected to OR gates and get outputs S0, S1, Sn minus 1. This is the output of the OR gates. Now this OR gates, now OR gates outputs is connected to inverter and non-inverter matrix. This matrix convert the complement form or uncomplement form. Next, 5 output buffer are required to increase device capability of PLA. The chip enable is applied to output buffer when CE complement equal to 0, output will be made available. Now 6 output through the flip-flop and buffer. If PLA is used for state machines applications, then output circuit consists of buffer and flip-flops. The OR gate output are connected to inputs of positive edge triggers, SR flip-flops. Flip-flop outputs are then applied to buffer. This is the programmable logic array